Welcome to what is one of hopefully many how-to videos for Meeples on Meeples. Today we're going to try to show you how to make a tabletop cover for your gaming table. If you're like most of us in our group here and from what I've seen around the internet, you have kind of a basic kitchen table that you use as your gaming table, which isn't always perfect. So today we're going to try to make a relatively low-cost, easy gaming table with some items you can pick up for around 50 bucks. Your first thing you're going to need is, you can't see on the camera right now, but it's some MDF board. It's a thick pressed wood board. We went with a half inch. It's a heavy board, shouldn't warp or anything. It'd be a good base for everything to go on top of. Next, you're going to need some spray adhesive. Looks like Loctite, high performance, middle weight. And then you're going to need the fabrics. As an underlayer, use kind of a thin layer of batting. Got this thing for about 24 bucks, actually I think $12 with a coupon. And then I think we went with the high grade felt. You can go with the lower grade felt. It may end up balling up on you though and cause some problems later on down the road. If you go with a little more expensive felt, it should last longer and hold up a little bit better. And finally, of course, you're going to need a table saw that'll help you cut the board to your table size, whether it's a round table or a straight table. If you're a round table, you're probably going to need a jigsaw, but for ours, it's a big rectangle table, so we've got this table saw. And then a staple gun, which will help you pull the fabric tight underneath, staple it underneath the MDF board and make sure it's nice and tight on top of it. That's kind of what you're going to need to get started, and let's get going on the table. Cut one. Always remember, measure twice, cut once. What we're doing is sanding the edge of the corners so with the fabric on, it does not pinch.
Right. That could be a gigantic waste.
Now that you have the boards cut, it's important to put down the batting and measure that to make sure it's going to fit over the boards. Probably the best way to do that is by putting the batting down and then laying the board on top of it. That way you can clearly see how big it needs to be so you have some overhang when you glue and staple it to the board. So that's what we're going to do.
I started doing about age 7, I started doing crafts. Thanks to my mother. And now you have extra, so when you're gonna be a ghost.
Or your cape.
It's a shawl.
That is our next video, actually. How to make game night shawls.
Hey, sometimes your head gets cold.
Nobody
likes. Everybody loves to show off. Kids out there that are very young and impressionable, everybody loves to show off. If your staple doesn't go all the way in, just use a hammer.
Alright, now that we have the batting done on both pieces, it's a very similar process for putting the felt down. You again, lay the felt down, lay the board down on top of it, and just make sure you have enough to go around every side of the board and get a nice tight fit over it. So, we're going to get cutting on that and glue it down just like we did with the batting. Thank you.
Alright, well, as you can see, we've got the felt glued on there now, and it's nice and smooth. It doesn't ball up. This is the first half. We got another half to go.
I think the staples definitely are a help on this. You have the glue holding it so it doesn't.
Got a jet flying over the street, let's say.
Yeah, I live near the airport.
We got the glue holds it nice and tight on the top, but then you have the extra security of those staples in the back that just pull the whole thing really tight across.
Yeah.
It worked well. All right, and this is what our table looks like set up. This is actually after one full playthrough. Fits pretty nicely on the tabletop, mm-hmm. I think. Nice and even, and the heavy board made it so it would stay, you know, level on the table.
Yeah, we didn't have to do anything special. It doesn't really move. You can push it around a little bit, and it's stuck down pretty good because the board actually weighs quite a bit. So.
Yeah, like I said, you can do this for about $50. You can get some coupons with your local fabric store, and it's pretty simple. We did it in, what, under 3 hours?
Yeah.
So give it a shot. Give us your thoughts on the video, and let us know what you think of the tabletop.